spaces between us. You have come to show you. Go on. Near, far, wherever.
My privilege to meet Pastor Adam Pearson shortly after I arrived in San Diego in 1959. His family and my family became close friends. I watched as his lovely family, his daughters and sons, grew up here in San Diego, and we often had fellowship together at the Jackson Memorial Church of God in Christ under the leadership of Bishop J. A. Blake, and after 1962 we continued to have fellowship at the St. Stephen's Church.
Higher Dimensions. It was a great church because we had great preaching, great word, great music. But we were a blessed church because we had some great people like Mom and Dad Pearson. We had spiritual parents. I guess his first name is Adam, but really in my mind, his first name is Dad. Dad Pearson. That's what we all call him. That's what we'll always call him, Dad Pearson. And that's really what he was. He was a dad. He had no desire for the limelight or the pulpit or microphone. He just wanted to be dad. And that's what he was. He was a dad to all of us, full of wisdom. Didn't speak often, but when he spoke, you heard from God. It was an awesome time getting to know him and to watch him with our people. Everybody loved Dad Pearson because he was that.
In 1973, I took a plane with two friends, Carlton and Gary, and we traveled to San Diego, California. There waiting for us at the airport was Adam Pearson, a gentle, kind, loving man with such a sweet spirit. He had the ability to make everybody feel comfortable. He loved everyone the same. He had the ability to pull out of you your self-esteem and to love yourself and to believe in yourself. He could make someone who was lonely and unattractive and very timid, he could bring out the beauty in them, and he made everyone feel like Miss America.
He's always been like a father figure, an encourager, a mentor. He was a man's man, and he loved God, but yet and still, he was a sensitive man. He loved people, and he always made you feel like $1 million when you came into his presence.
That's true. That is the truth. He could make the smallest person, the most insignificant feeling person, feel like you own the world.
Yes.
He had the special ability to do just that.
I never had an encounter with him where I didn't walk away feeling better than before.
He was such a kind, sweet man. Every time I saw him, he was happy. He always had something sweet to say and kind. And when we would greet each other, he would hug me, we'd smile, and he said, "I love you and I like you." And the first time he said that, when we first came to Tulsa, I kind of looked at him and he said, "Well, you know, you can love somebody, but you don't always like them." So we would laugh about that, but he would always say that when we greeted each other, "I love you and I like you." And I said, "I love you too, Daddy."
One time and last for a lifetime, and never let go till we're gone. Love was when I loved you one true time. I'd hold you in my life will always grow.
Grieving with hope, happy, sad at Dad Pearson's passing. I remember him being funny. In fact, a lot funnier than you, Carlton. He was funny.
I remember your dad. All of the years that I was there at Higher Dimensions, he was always quick with a joke.
One time on my mom and dad's 30th anniversary, I heard my dad went out and bought my mom this beautiful dress when we were kids back in California, 25th anniversary. And she just went on about it because he didn't do that all the time. He went out and bought her a full dress. When you got six kids to eat, you know, mama bought her own dresses and daddy was happy when she did. But he actually went out and bought one and brought it home and she bragged and she went on and on and on about it. And I wondered what his response would be. And if she got so, honey, you didn't have to do it. We got all these kids. I can't believe it. She went through the whole thing. And my dad said, that's nothing, girls. Stick with me another 30 years and I'll throw in a pair of shoes.
He was always sharply dressed. Any time you saw Daddy Pearson, his jeans were ironed with the creases in them. He was always clean. If he was casual, he was clean. On Sunday, I'd see him and I'd say, Daddy, you're looking awful sharp today. And he'd step back and he said, oh, you're just saying it because it's true.
Well, it is an honor to be able to say a few words on behalf of Dad Pearson. I am traveling on the road and I'm not in the best place possible, but I am in the best place where there's the best lighting that happens to be in the bathroom. So honoring Dad Pearson live from the Stuvel. The thing that I remember most about Dad Pearson was that laugh of his.
You're kidding.
You good.
I am kidding.
And I'm sure there's going to be a lot of things said about him. But that laugh came from way down deep and it had this sort of husky quality to it. And I remember hearing him and my dad laugh all the time and they were buddies. And my father had nicknames for everybody. And because dad had this little hairdo that kind of combed up on top of his head, you know, my dad said that he reminded him of Sugar Ray Robinson. So he used to call him Sugar Ray Pearson. And when I was at church, and if my dad was sick, he would always ask me about Sugar Ray. He says, how's Sugar Ray doing? I said, Sugar Ray is fine. And I remember Dad Pearson and Mom Pearson were the first people that were there when my father passed away. Carlton was there. And Carlton, his ministry had to emanate from somewhere. It had to come from somewhere. And it was birthed in that home. With those parents, with that father. And he was a dad, and he was a husband, and he loved Jesus to the very end. And there's no greater legacy than can be said about a man than that. For we live to die, die only to live again. He's more a part of our future than he will be a part of our past. And we will all see him again, and we will hear that laugh, and we'll remember how much we missed him.
He was a great man. He was like a father figure to me. When my father and Dad Pearson were in church together and they saw each other, which happened every once in a while, it was like old friends meeting. They were just wonderful together and blessed. He blessed me in so many ways and will continue to bless me as he will continue to bless all of us.
I was deeply saddened to hear of the passing of your father. It made me instantly remember the passing of my own father. I remember that when my father passed, our dads were our heroes. I know your dad was your hero. When these great men pass from our lives, it leaves us feeling a little bit uncovered, but it also elevates us into that position and that role to be the mentor for all of the young men who follow. I know that you have many young men who follow you, and I know you're an excellent mentor, and I champion you for that. This is going to be a new season for you.
I'm telling you, love was something that he exemplified to everybody.
Unconditional
love. And I never ever saw Dad, you know, put anybody down, talk about people or anything. And he loved his family, he loved his wife, but he loved people, period.
I would like to say thank you all for sharing Dad Pearson, not only with my family, but to so many others who love him. I would like to say that it was an honor and a privilege for me and my family and my son especially to spend time with him a couple of days before he departed Earth at that time.
I remember Dad Pearson coming to preach for me when I had a little church in Louisiana. And he'd preach a while, and then he'd tell Mother Pearson, he'd say, "Now read." And he said it with authority. And of course, Mother Pearson could read like nobody could read. But I just love you guys, Bishop Pearson, all the Pearsons. I love you all so very much, and thank God for the impact that you made on my life. Let me say one more thing. Dad taught us the essential qualities of being a good human being and also a spiritual being. His love for horses, God's creation, he had an attraction to them, he had an appeal with them. And it just spoke volumes to me about him as a human, but also as a spiritual man. He taught us how to live right, serve God, serve the purpose of God in the earth before we fall asleep.
In 2003, my wife Loretta and I had just recently married a few months earlier, and we came to Higher Dimensions to see Bishop Pearson and some of the rest of the saints there at Higher D. And as we were walking into the church, Dad Pearson, we met him coming in the door. And of course, he remembered me from Azusa days several years earlier. And he looked at me and my wife and he said, "How are you doing?" And I said, "We're doing well. We just recently got married." He said, "Well, how long have you been married?" I said, "Well, we've been married only a few months." And he smiled at me with that little sheepish smile. And he patted me on my shoulder and he said, "Keep on, son. We've been married 55 years and I'm still doing time."
My parents would be celebrating 68 years had Daddy lived to April 26th. But every time I would celebrate my parents' wedding, and people that live together that long should get Nobel Peace Prizes. Or something, right? So I said, sorry. I said to my dad, 68 years, Daddy. I say that every year for their anniversary. He said, "Yes, son, 68 years and I'm still doing time." He had that kind of sense of humor. He woke out of a dead sleep the other night. two nights before he transitioned, and he just burst into this Nat King Cole love song. We've never heard, my mother never heard it before. I got it on tape. You want me to show it to you? Put it on the screen up there. I got it.
"Magic is the moonlight.
Turn it so Dad can see.
On this lover's June night. For it made you mine. Living in the splendor of your kiss so tender made my heart surrender to your love divine."
I've never heard him sing that.
Mom, we love you. You're the other half. You are the inspiration, the outspoken. And we thank God for you, and we'll be praying for you. You yet have days with us. and you will make your contribution, and you have made great contributions. We love you, we support you, and we'll always be here for you. We love you, Mom Pearson.
And well, you know, the other thing is that you never saw Dad Pearson without Mom Pearson. And I just, I love you so much. I appreciate the impact that you and your husband have had in this earth and are having. And you personally, I just, you know, such a strong woman of God. And I so enjoyed being a part of you, being a part of our recordings at Azusa. And I'm a soldier! Love it. Love your spirit. Love the patriarch that you are, not only to your family, but really to many in the body of Christ. And I honor you and appreciate you. And I know that your best days are ahead.
Mom, I want you to know that we, again, honor you and your family and thank God for, I remember with just much joy, the staff meetings where we would sit and you would be there and laugh with us and be really one of my first pictures and understanding of what a real mother of the church was. I didn't grow up in the church, and so to see that in you, I just bless you and honor you, again, Lori and myself and many from our church family here on the east side of Tulsa. You would know if you saw them, are grieving with you and covering you in our prayers. And want to honor you and your family, and just may the Lord bless you and keep you and make his face shine on you. God bless you.
And now it is my privilege to extend a word of encouragement and a word of comfort to Bishop Pearson and all of the Pearson family. We have been involved now for more than 50 years. I participated in the life of this family, and we consider the Pearson family to be a very close-knit one with the McKinney family and the St. Stephen's Fellowship. I pray that God will give comfort to you. I pray that God will strengthen you. I pray that God will give you the courage and the peace during this season of transition. We know that when the earthly house of this tabernacle is dissolved, we have another building of God that is not made with hands. We know that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And the word of God declares that blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, for they shall rest from their labors and their works do follow. Pastor Adam Pearson is resting in the arms of Jesus. Let us continue the work and the legacy. Let us honor his memory by loving one another, by sharing each other's burdens, and by continuing the evangelism outreach that he conducted during his sojourn here. God bless you is my prayer.
Amen.